Hi, my name is Dori Varas and I'm a product manager in Secure Access Cloud. It is my pleasure to present our newest release feature, RDP Multi-Target Application. This feature was designed to reduce the management burden from the Secure Access Cloud admins. This is achieved by dramatically reducing the number of needed RDP applications and access policies. I'll quickly walk you through the configuration. This is my Secure Access Cloud tenant, and it's integrated with my Azure AD to provide me with single sign-on capabilities. I can log in with my corporate credentials. I will be redirected back to my Azure AD tenant to complete the authentication. And following a successful authentication, I'm redirected back into Secure Access Cloud, where all of the applications that are assigned to me exist. Now, let's review the IDP integration. Let's go to the admin portal under settings, identity providers, and we are using Azure AD. Here, you can see that I reference a specific user attribute that will be leveraged to hold the user's allowed RDP target list. I'll show you how it looks in Azure AD in a second. I'm saving it here, and let's go to Azure AD. In Azure, I've created these custom attributes, and you can see from this user printout that the user that we are using has three targets assigned to it. We have new comp A, comp 2, and an explicit IP. This comes to show you that it doesn't really matter for Secure Access Cloud if you provide a name or an explicit IP. We will be able to translate one into the other. Now, let's go back to the Secure Access Cloud site and I'll show you how the configuration looks there. In the admin portal, I'll go to Applications, click on New, and select an RDP application. I'll give it a meaningful name like Multi-Site A, and I will change the configuration from a single computer application to multiple computer application. By doing so, you will notice that the internal address becomes grayed out as it is no longer relevant. We will be receiving the names or IPs of allowed targets based on the user attribute. Next, I will assign the application to a site and assign an access policy with the appropriate permissions. I've created one in advance. I'll click Confirm and Save. Now, after a quick health validation, the application will be up and running and I will show you how it looks. Okay, now that the application is saved and is online, we can go to the application portal and I'll show you how it looks from the user side. In the application portal, you can see the newly created application is assigned to this user. I'll launch it and I can now select to which target I'd like to connect. This is all based on the values that exist in the user attribute. I'll select this one and download an RDP file. Once the RDP file is downloaded, I can launch it. I will use the provided username and one-time password for the RDP connection. And after a quick validation, I should be able to connect to the target I was trying to hit. Now, following a successful connection to this target, if the user would like to connect to a different target, all they have to do is launch the same application again, select the different target, and download an RDP file. Once downloaded, we repeat the same process, provide the username, the password, and we are connected. Again, all of this is achieved by using a single RDP application and a single access policy. No duplication of the application is required, no multiple access policy, which can be hard to maintain. Thank you for watching this demo for RDP multi-target application.